Hello again. Mining strategist Christopher Ecclestone joins us now at the Proactive Investor Studio here in London. And Christopher, you're here to talk to us about Sri Lanka and graphite. Why do those two go together particularly?
Traditionally, Sri Lanka has a long history, hundreds of years, of being known for two products, tea and the other one is graphite. Since independence, the graphite has faded away and is not heard of that much, but now there's a big resurgence going on in the graphite space within Sri Lanka, and one of the companies leading that is Ceylon Graphite.
And it's a particular type of graphite not found anywhere else in the world, isn't it?
Very, very true. The reason why, well, the graphite traditionally has been used for two things. One is pencils, pencil lead, which everybody knows, and the other one is for making crucibles for crucibles and refractory materials for the steel industry and other sort of smelting industries. And the graphite in Sri Lanka or Ceylon was found to be particularly useful for making pencil leads, and so for hundreds of years it was the main source of that.
Is it called vein graphite?
Vein graphite, absolutely. Vein, yeah.
To be specific.
Which the reason is because it's in mainly in vertical veins, whereas many of the other graphite deposits you hear about are in sort of like in horizontal layers, like sort of shale type deposits.
Now, the boss who's running it is something of a character. Eccentric might be going too far, but tell us about Bharat. What's special about him heading up this
Bharat
company?
Bharat is a very interesting guy that runs this company. Traditionally, many of these mining companies, particularly the graphite ones, are run by geologists with, dare I say, their obsession with drilling and, proving up resources and then writing reports and more press releases and more reports. In Bharat's case, he saw the potential, because the potential is well known in Sri Lanka. Went there, got his geos in on the investigation, proved that there was substantial vein swarms and sizable ones and high grade ones at his various deposits. He's got two main ones, and so he just decided, are these mineable? And now he's moving forward as fast as he can into getting them into production.
And he's a businessman, so
he really is
focused on production rather than just running a company.
He has led various major branches of Salomon Smith Barney in Asia for decades now. So he's an investment banker. So he knows that side and he knows what the market wants, production.
Talking about the market, you've just written a sector piece on graphite. What is international demand and where's it heading?
Well, as I said before, the traditional demand has been in refractories and in crucibles and things like that. But now graphite's coming into its own as one of the less known battery metals. So you hear about lithium a lot, you hear about cobalt a lot, but graphite is used in the all the EV batteries, and so graphite now has this enormous new source of demand coming from the electric vehicle market.
So to match that new demand from the EV market, what is the growth strategy? What is the production strategy?
Well, if we look back at this space in recent years, there was a brief flurry in 2012, 2013, when graphite first came to the attention of the markets, the mining markets. And so there were a flock of new participants appear, wannabes, if we want to call them that. But of that group, only really one has got into production, that is Syrah. Which is an Australian company with a big mine in Mozambique. But, none of the others have actually come to production. So despite the fact that they had a bit of a head start on Ceylon Graphite, which is a relatively newcomer in the space, Ceylon Graphite's going to sort of like leapfrog over them by leaving them behind with their, some of them have many bloated projects with very large capex that are unfinanceable at the moment. So with a cheap and cheerful get it out of the ground and get it on the market strategy, Bharat and Ceylon Graphite are looking to leapfrog the rest of the graphite space.
And that's why investors should be sitting up and listening to what you have to say about this company.
It's there. I mean, I think the proof of the pudding's in the eating. I think he's dedicated to production and you can't beat production.
Christopher Ecclestone, great to talk to you. Thanks very much indeed.
Thank you.